I want to welcome you to this edition of Finish Line, and I am sitting here with the First Assistant General Overseer of the Church of God, Dr. Raymond F. Culpepper, but even more than that, my dear friend that we've had wonderful times of ministry with throughout the years. We're talking specifically today about what it means to be a Spirit-led and a Spirit-empowered church in this day and time in which we live. We're actually sitting here, Dr. Culpepper, in the oldest continuing Pentecostal church in North America, the North Cleveland Church of God. Before we finish our conversation, I'm going to be sharing with you some resources that Dr. Culpepper has about the baptism of the Holy Spirit, also a book that I have prepared with several writers assisting me on the Holy Spirit. But for a few moments, Brother Culpepper, I just want to talk about the ministry of the Holy Spirit in this world today. You have written a book. You actually shared with me that you wrote this some years ago during the height of the charismatic renewal, just about the time you were beginning your church in Birmingham, the great, great metro church. Talk to us about the heart of this book. Why did you write this book? Why was it necessary at the time?
Well, at the time, there was just a tidal wave of people coming into learning about the Holy Spirit from everywhere. And I found myself having to preach and teach about the gifts of the Spirit and the Holy Spirit, speaking in tongues, about twice a year. And that would take an elongated series of 5 to 6 to 7 weeks.
Sure.
So I wrote this book. It has 24 of the most often asked questions that I found as a pastor people ask about the Holy Spirit.
Right.
For example, people want to know, who is the Holy Spirit?
Yeah.
Was the Holy Spirit involved in the Old Testament?
Mm-hmm.
What are different kinds of tongues that the Bible talks about? And there are many different kinds of tongues. Spiritual gifts.
Mm.
That was an area that very little was known at the time about spiritual gifts. So I wrote this book to inform and share with my people. And it has truly been a wonderful resource for people who just really want to scratch the surface of the Holy Spirit.
24 questions that are asked and answered.
And answered.
In here. 24 small chapters. That book is only about 81 or 2 pages. A great read. And I think it's a timely read. And really, it's transcended time, because you wrote this, I think you said, in the early 80s to mid-80s?
Mid-80s.
And here we are in 2017, and this book is still in demand. But more than the book being in demand, the power of the Holy Spirit is in demand today and is available today. Brother Culpepper, you serve this church as General Overseer, and you have traveled this world. You have seen great moves of the Holy Spirit. But talk to us about the move of the Holy Spirit that you saw firsthand in the Metro Church in Birmingham, Alabama. God called you and Peggy there. You had nobody. Just a handful of people in the beginning. But it became a great, great church with a Pentecostal emphasis. What did you see over those years?
Well, I saw two things. Number one, prayer.
Hmm.
I think prayer was the driving force behind everything that happened. We started a 4:30 a.m. prayer that ran for several years,
wow,
5 mornings a week, and it continued several years. And I believe out of that prayer effort by a few people, God heard and answered prayer, and we saw such overwhelming results. Then we caught the charismatic renewal.
Mm-hmm.
Where we opened our hearts and our arms and we welcomed people into the church. And there were several, not one or two or three, but Sundays. We received members in every first Sunday of the month. And there was one month we had 168 new members.
Wow.
In one month.
Wow.
Several months, over 100 members would join the church. And I woke up one morning and I thought, you know, I am not doing anything different. This must be the work of the Holy Spirit.
Wow, wow.
So I do attribute everything that happened there for those 24 years to a sovereign work of God.
Amen.
I'm humbled that it happened and that I was that close to it. But I'll tell you right now, that was the work of the Holy Spirit.
Oh, definitely. And I've been to that great church, as many of you that are watching have been to that great church as well. I can share that same testimony in my own life, in my own experience as an evangelist, as a pastor, as a leader. We need a fresh outpouring and a fresh Amen. Infilling of the Holy Spirit. One of the things that the executive committee is doing right now, we are emphasizing Pentecost Sunday. You know, one of the great days on the calendar for a Spirit-led believer is that day, because it is a day that we commemorate. It's a day we celebrate, but it's also a great day to experience a fresh outpouring. Even as I'm saying that, I'm remembering my childhood. I remember back in the day that there was a special edition of the Evangel that came out prior to Pentecost Sunday. We still do that. But I remember, the reason I'm telling this story, I remember back in the day when my dad pastored in my childhood, that was the time that we would canvas, literally canvas our community mm-hmm. and pass out that edition of the Evangel. Yeah. Put one in every door, put one in the hands of the people that live there. And we saw tremendous results of that back in that day. But the passion is still here in this day and in this time. And the executive committee is doing our best to resource pastors and churches throughout the month of May so that you can preach every Sunday in the month of May on the baptism of the Holy Spirit, the gifts of the Spirit, the fruits of the Spirit. We've even got a message that we can send you for Mother's Day. Wouldn't that be a great idea to preach on the baptism of the Holy Spirit on Mother's Day leading up to June the 4th? I want you to join in this emphasis with us. We're calling the entire month of May Preparing for Pentecost, and it will culminate on the first Sunday of June. But think about that, preparing for Pentecost. If 1.3 million members of the Church of God just in North America would emphasize Pentecost for an entire 31 days and then culminate that with a great celebration on June the 4th, I believe it would be explosive, Brother Culpepper.
It would be.
And then think what happens if that gets beyond the borders of our North American continent and spans the globe with the other 7 million members that we have in the Church of God. I believe God wants to give us a fresh outpouring of His Holy Spirit. Brother Culpepper, I just appreciate you being with me today for this edition of Finish Line. And I just marvel being in this historic place today. This is the North Cleveland Church of God, the old chapel, the church that actually was built when Dr. T.L. Lowry pastored here, the building. And on these grounds, on these very grounds in history for the Church of God is where A.J. Tomlinson and some of our early leaders in this movement experienced Pentecost for themselves. And it's just significant for us to be here today. But you know what? It just can't be a memory.
No.
It can't be in our past. Pentecost has got to be in our present and remain in our future. Brother Culpepper, I just would hope that you would share any other comment from your heart. But then I want you to pray for those that are watching to experience a fresh infilling of the Holy Spirit.
Let's just pray.
Amen.
Father, we feel your Holy Spirit even here in this room.
Hallelujah.
And it's not the room itself.
No.
We know that your presence is the abiding presence of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
And that is being felt wherever this video is being shown. I believe that.
Hmm.
And I pray for every church, every pastor, every leader throughout the world.
In Jesus' name.
I pray that we will hold up the flag of Pentecost.
Yes, Lord.
Whatever we call it, whether we call it Spirit-filled, or whatever our terminology may be, that we would hold up the flag of the Holy Spirit baptism in the life of the believer.
Yes, Lord.
And that, Father, on Pentecost Sunday,
do it, Lord,
throughout the world, the Church of God will celebrate the wonderful coming and remaining and enduing with power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Culpepper, for that wonderful prayer. Our mission in the Church of God is to proclaim the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ in the spirit and the power of Pentecost. Let's preach about it throughout the month of May. Let's experience it on June the 4th. These resources are available to you. Contact Pathway Press. They'll see that you get them in a quick amount of time, a short amount of time. Let me also say that the Executive Committee is preparing a sermon series that we will be making available to you electronically. And you can see there on the screen how to avail yourself to it. It's absolutely free at no charge. And we have priced these books very minimally so that they can be accessible to anyone who would want them. The Holy Spirit, understanding His purpose, experiencing His power, the ministry of the Holy Spirit, understanding the ministry of the Holy Spirit by Dr. Raymond Culpepper. Get these resources and let's experience revival on June the 4th. Thank you for watching Finish Line. God bless you.